That's customer service.
Yes, sir. Who is this?
This is Fred in customer service.
Yes, sir. I was wondering if you could help me with something.
Well, I'll do what I can.
Look here, I bought one of them things y'all makes that you cooks a chicken on top of, you know, where you push a can of beer in that little wire you hold and sets the chicken up on top of, you know, sticks the can of beer up the chicken's behind.
Yeah.
Well, my son had cooked a chicken on it, and it really turned out good. I mean, that meat was juicy and tender, and it just fell off the bone. It's about the best chicken I ever had in my life.
I tell you what, it's fantastic. We cook them that way all the time. I'm glad you liked it.
Well, let me tell you what happened. Last night, I was going to try it out myself.
Yes.
And I did just like my son told me to. I put that can of beer inside that place and put some barbecue rub all over the outside and the inside the chicken. And I put it away on the other side, away from the coals, just like
that's
he
right.
said to do. And I had it in a pan so the fat wouldn't drip out and start no fire.
Hey, that's right. You need to put it on, you know, not over the fire, but on the other side. You did it right. I'm glad you liked it.
Well, I must not have, because I had went back in the house to sit there and watch TV while the chicken was cooking, and I heard this big explosion. Man, it sounded like a bomb going off.
A bomb?
Yeah. I went outside, and it had blew the top off my barbecue pit, and there was pieces of chicken stuck to the ceiling of the back porch all over the screen door. Everywhere there was chicken meat and bones, and I'm talking about all over everything.
Oh, that's unreal. You must have a gas problem or something.
Well, no, I had that gas problem last week, but a dose of that Pepto, and it was gone in about a day.
That's not, well, I mean, you know, nothing like this happened before. I've never even heard of that. There's nothing on there. There's nothing in that thing that can explode at all. Something must be bad wrong.
Well, it sure happened to me. Is you calling me a liar?
Well, no, sir, I'm not calling you a liar. I wouldn't do that, but it's we've just never had anything like this ever happen.
Well, what y'all gonna do about it?
Well, I don't know what to do about it. I really don't think it's our fault.
Well, I do. I've cooked hundreds of chickens on that charcoal grill, and I ain't never had one blow up till I used y'all's thing to cook with.
Huh. Well, you said you put the beer can in, and then you set it away from a direct heat on the other side.
Sure did, just like my boy told me to.
Okay, well, how much beer did you leave in the can?
Well, it was the whole can. My son told me that he used half a can, but I really likes beer, and I figured a whole can would make it, you know, a whole lot better.
Well, that shouldn't have made any difference.
Well, it was a real big chicken, so I used one of them tall boys, you know, real tall cans of beer. I mean, that hot beer went everywhere, burnt the hair off my cat that was laying on the poach. You can see his hide where the poor thing's burned. It just lay around and moaning all day, you know.
I don't want to offend you, but if you mind if I ask you a question? I mean, it may sound kind of stupid, but
you ain't gonna offend me. You seem like a nice fella. Go ahead and ask me whatever you want to. I just want to get this figured out.
I know it's kind of a stupid question, but you did open the beer can first, didn't you?
Well, no, my boy didn't say nothing about opening the can.
You opened the beer can first. Golly, no wonder it explodes. You ever left a hot beer can out in the sun and it gets hot and it'll just blow up by itself? I can imagine what happened if you put it on a fire, didn't know.
You ought not be laughing at me. I didn't know no better.
Hold on a minute. Sir, I'm sorry. Hold on a minute. Oh, man, I just think about that can explode blowing chicken in
the air. Well, it ain't nice to be laughing at your customers.
I'm sorry. I really am. I can't help them. Nobody got hurt, did they?
No. Well, reckon y'all could send me enough money to buy another chicken and another can of beer and something to clean all this mess up with?
No, sir, I don't think we could do that.
Well, y'all about the sorriest excuse for a chicken barbecue company I ever heard of.
Well, we're not really a chicken barbecuing company, but an explosion wasn't our fault. You should open the beer can. I mean, most people, they open the can, drink about half of it, put the other half in the chicken thing and put the chicken over that. That's the right way to
do it. Well, I had done drank the other five cans in that six-pack. That's probably why I forgot to open that last one for the chicken.
That's a good chance of it. No. Man, I'm sorry you had that problem. Are you okay with us now? I mean,
oh, yeah, I guess so.
Well, I tell you what I'm going to do, since you're so nice, and that phone call made my day. I mean, I'm sorry for your problem. But,
yeah.
You know, but we'll make some real nice fish cookers and the big old pots with baskets stuff for cooking fat catfish, and I'm going to send you a little something in the mail there.
Lord, I bet you got to put a quart of beer in one of them pots, don't you?
No, just cooking oil, no grease.
Okay, then. I sure would appreciate it. Look here, I got to run there. I'll call back with my address. I got to get out here and start cleaning.
If I'm going to send you something, I need to get your address.
Yeah, I'll call you back. I got to get out here and clean this mess up right now.
Okay, well, thanks for calling, and you have a nice day.
You too, sir. Bye-bye.